Hello student friends, in this today's talk under molecular symmetry and group theory, I am going to cover the subgroups or sub elements associated with CN element as well as the SN element. So in this we want to consider the three subcategories. One is that CN element when N is even or odd. So okay, even number means okay, 2, 4, 6 like that. In C2 exosymmetry or C4 exosymmetry or C6 exosymmetry, or when odd like okay, C3, C5 and so on. So in CN element, each CN element generates N subgroups. And this is CN one, CN2, CN3, CN4 up to CN2N. Note. So for example, when you take here a C3 element, so each C3 generates the N. Here N is equal to 3, means 3 sub elements. These are C3 1, C3 twice, C3 3. If you are going for C4 element, each C4 generated 4 sub-elements, C4-1, C4-2, C4-3, C4-4. Similarly, if there is benzene, you know that C6 is the exosymmetry, principal exosymmetry. Each C6 consists of these 6 sub-elements, and these are C6-1, C6-2, C6-3, C6-4, C6-5, C6-6. Then, want to simplify this one? Okay, if you are going to see C3 consists of this C3 1, C3 twice and C3 3. So C3 1, there is no any collinear element to this one, this is as it is. C3 twice, it is as it is. C3 3, as per the identity, you know that. So here just we have discussed already. So here C3 3, we know that as per the property of identity rule, which results the original orientation of molecule. Means if you're operating three types, triple exosymmetry on ammonia molecule or PH3 or AB3 molecule, we are getting the original orientation of molecule. So it is equal to E. So C3 element generates the three sub-elements, and these are E, C3 1, C3 twice. Similarly, if you're going for C4, these are the four CVS. Four sub-elements, and in this case C4 1, this is as it is. C4 twice means 2 times 4-fold exosymmetry. This is to be simplified as C2 1, means divided by here 2 divided by 2, means it is C2 1. Means in another words, one can say that when we operate 2 times 4-fold exosymmetry on a molecule, we are getting the orientation. The same orientation is to be obtained by performing one time 2-fold exosymmetry. Means here, you know that. And 4 means the angle of rotation is 90. And 2 means here, angle of rotation is 180. Means 2 times 90. So it is 1 time 180. So it is the collinear. These two are collinear. So this is after simplification, we are getting C2 1. There is no collinear element to this one, and this C4 4 is E. So reverse that, the C4 generated the 4 sub-elements as E, C4 1, C2 1, and C4 the thrice. Similarly, if you are going for C6, these are the the 6 sub-elements, and these simplified as this one as it is. This is simplified, or C6 2 is collinear to C3 1, is divided by 2 divided by 2 here. So C3 1, so this simplified as C2 1. This is to be simplified as C3 twice. This is no collinear to this one. C6 6, it is E. So if you are going to see benzene as the example, it has the C6 as the principal axis of symmetry. And this principal axis of symmetry generates E, C6 1, C3 1, C2 1, C3 twice, and C6 5 as the six sub elements. So this is regarding Cn element when n is even or odd. Then Sn element when n is even. As like again, Cn element when n is even or odd, each Sn element generates n sub-elements. And these again from Sn1, Sn2, Sn3, Sn4 up to Snn. Okay, means even number means, for example, if you're going to see this one S4. S4 again generates S41, S42, S43, and S44. So S44, 41 is as it is. Okay, this S42 after simplification, it is C21. Okay, C21. Why C21? Because you know that this S4:2, one can write in terms of C and say sigma as C4:2 into sigma^2. So sigma^2 is E. And this C42 is to be written as C21. C21 into E, it is C21. No collinear element to this one. And S4:4 is E. So S4 giving these sub elements as E, S41, C21, S4 thrice. Similarly, if there is a S6, generate these six sub elements. And these are S61, S6 twice, S6 thrice, S6 4, S6 5, and E. So here no collinear element to this one, no collinear element to this one, and this is E. But here S6 2 is to be written like this one. Okay, C3 1 means this is collinear element. Means collinear element means when you operate S6 4 means four times sixfold improper axial symmetry, we are getting the orientation. The same orientation is to be obtained by operating one time three pole axial symmetry. And S6:3 after simplification we are getting S2:1, and S6:4 after simplification we are getting C3:2. So S6 generates these six sub elements. Then regarding this one. Sn element when n is odd, it's like S3, S5. Each Sn element generates two n sub elements. In these two cases, there is only n sub elements according to the this fold. It is but in Sn element when n is odd, means if n is 3, if n is equal to 3, it generates six sub elements. If n is equal to 5, there are 10 sub elements, and these are Sn^1, Sn^2, Sn^n up to Sn^n. Then beyond that, Sn^n+1, Sn^n+2, like that. Sn^n+n means 2n. No doubt. So if I want to see examples like this one, S3, there are six sub elements like this one. How these are? S3 1, then next is S3 2, next is S3 3, next is S3 4, S3 5, and last is E. So this S3 1 and S3 5, no collinear element to this one, but S3 2 is simplified like C3:2. Then S3, S3 3 is simply sigma. Then S3:4, why it is C3 1? Just you see S3:4, it is written as C3:4 into sigma^4. Then C3:4, it is collinear to the C3 1. Why? Just you see, this is ammonia molecule C3 1. You are getting this orientation. Again, if you are going for second time, you are getting this orientation. Then if you are going for C3 3, we are reaching to the original. Again, four time three pole axial symmetry, we are getting this one. So this orientation, when you operate C3 1 on this ammonia, we are getting this orientation. The same orientation is to be obtained by four time three pole axial symmetry. Means reverse that. C3:4 is collinear to this one. So this is C3 1, and then sigma^4, it is identity. So C3 1 into identity, it is simply C3 1. So it is simply C3 1. So in this case, we are getting a S3 toys, sigma, C31, S35, and E. So these are the sub elements of S3. And S5, so here there is mistake. Okay, it generates the 10 sub elements. Okay, like if you are going to see S51, S52, S53, S54, S55, S56, S57, S58, S59, and S518. So this is regarding the subgroups or sub elements associated with SN element when n is even or odd. SN element, and n is even. In these two cases, we are getting n sub elements. But when SN element, when n is odd, we are each SN element generates the two n sub elements. So with this, I conclude regarding the sub elements or subgroup associated with the X of symmetry and the improper X of symmetry. Thank you so much.